Hello everyone, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program RP-1. Today, you will see two of my missions to Mars. The launch you see now is the beginning of Aphrodite mission. It is a Martian moon hopper. It will visit both natural satellites of Red Planet. It is launched on the workhorse rocket of my space program, Golem. The ascent went according to the plan, and the payload was released to low Earth orbit. Subsequently, the upper stage performs aggressive deorbit maneuver. TMI burn is performed nominally. After a short while, correction maneuver puts Aphrodite on its way to Mars. Probe separates from the transfer stage and enters standby mode for the transfer that will take 290 days. Second mission launching in the same transfer window is the RSS Retrieval. It's a return mission that will bring some surface samples to Earth. It's a much more demanding mission profile, so the rocket used for it is Naga, capable of getting 100 tons to LEO, and which is powered by pentaboron, making a beautiful green plume. Craft consists of orbiter and a lander. Lander will get to the surface, take the sample, and the Mars ascent vehicle will get to the orbiter. Then the orbiter will burn towards Earth. Maneuver is plotted and the engines are lit for trans-Martian injection. After separation from the transfer stage, correction maneuver puts the craft on final trajectory. Days later, despite leaving second, RSS Retrieval arrives to its destination 3 days before Aphrodite. It performs another correction burn upon entering Mars SOI to fine-tune the approach. Later, 11 minutes insertion burn puts probe on slightly elliptical orbit. And then, at apoapsis, short maneuver brings trajectory into the atmosphere. Lander is released from the transfer stage, as well as the orbiter. Then, the orbiter performs periapsis raising maneuver, and it will wait in orbit for the surface sample. Coming back to the lander, it softly aerobrakes in Mars' sparse atmosphere. Thank you. Eventually, it sheds its aero cover, deploys parachutes, and jettisons heat shield. At 1000 meters, parachutes are cut and power descent begins. Landing was a bit rough, but nevertheless successful. Solar panels are unfolded, science instruments are turned on, and the scientific part of the mission starts. Data will be gathered for over a year by waiting for the return window to open. And in the meantime, Aphrodite arrives. It performs injection burn and enters highly elliptical orbit. Then, at the apoapsis, it burns to rendezvous with the outer moon, Deimos. Almost 3 days later, the moon is getting bigger and bigger, and expanding 400 meters per second from delta V budget brings the craft into a nice orbit with overwhelming orbital velocity of 3.5 meters per second. Now, Aphrodite probe separates from the transfer stage and heads towards the surface. Touchdown was extremely smooth and probe starts to collect scientific data, which will take about 3 months. For this duration, it is powered by 3 small RTGs. Transfer stage stays in orbit and its mission for that time is to relay data back to Earth. After all the data has been collected, probe lifts from the ground and heads back to the transfer stage. Rendezvous was extremely easy thanks to virtually inexistent gravity of Deimos. Probe just pointed towards the target and after a short bit of time, it was docked. Before leaving Deimos, Aphrodite made a flyby of an interesting surface feature, a huge spike at the pole. There are many hypotheses on how it was formed, from aliens to glitching matrix. Maybe we will never know the truth. But coming back to the mission plan, Probe leaves the Deimos SOI and prepares to meet Phobos. After achieving orbit, Probe separates from the transfer stage one more time. Getting to landing approach needed just a bit of RSS paths. Landing site was a bit more rough, but I could easily find a good spot at which lander will stay for the rest of its mission, gathering science and enjoying beautiful view of Mars. And finally, RS Retrieval begins its journey back. Lipstick to Zero begins its climb through Martian atmosphere. It is powered by generic Aerosene 50 NTO thruster, which allows craft to be a single stage to orbit. After accelerating to desired apoapsis, engine shuts down, and then lights once again to circularize the orbit. Using leftover fuel, orbit is raised a bit to better match the trajectory of orbiter. So Rendezvous will need less delta V. After over a year of waiting, Orbiter wakes up and proceeds with Rendezvous and Capture. Thank you. capture is performed by Big Arm that will secure connection and move the sample from lipstick to return pod. After transferring the sample to the orbiter, the whole arm is being jettisoned to reduce mass. After additional 80 days in orbit, return window finally opens, and over 2 km per second burn sets the craft on return trajectory. Travel time was 280 days. Almost 3000 kilometers over Earth, craft entered a slow spin before releasing the lander. It ensured that the pod will keep proper orientation upon re-entry. Descent profile was quite aggressive, with peak G-load of 29 Gs, which decreased total heat load on the vessel, so the heat shield still had around 30% of its initial ablator. Parachutes ensured soft landing in water, where the craft was recovered, and the surface sample was transported for studies. That would be all for today. Thank you everyone for watching, please press like and subscribe if you enjoyed it, and see you again in my next video.